Adenoids. What are adenoids? The nasopharyngeal tonsils, commonly called adenoids, is situated at the junction of the roof and posterior wall of the nasopharynx. Adenoid tissue is present at birth, shows physiological enlargement up to the age of 6 years, and then tends to atrophy at puberty and almost completely disappears by the age of 20. Why and when do they cause trouble? Adenoids are subject to physiological enlargement in childhood. Certain children have a tendency to generalized lymphoid hyperplasia, in which adenoids also take part. Recurrent attacks of rhinitis, sinusitis, or chronic tonsillitis may cause chronic adenoid infection and hyperplasia. Allergy of the upper respiratory tract may also contribute to the enlargement of adenoids. Clinical features. Symptoms and signs depend not merely on the absolute size of the adenoid mass, but are relative to the available space in the nasopharynx. Enlarged and infected adenoids may cause nasal, oral, ear, or general symptoms. A. Nasal symptoms. 1. Nasal obstruction is the commonest symptom. This leads to mouth breathing. Nasal obstruction also interferes with feeding or suckling a child. As respiration and feeding cannot take place simultaneously, a child with adenoid enlargement fails to thrive. 2. Nasal discharge. It is partly due to coanal obstruction, as the normal nasal secretions cannot drain into nasopharynx, and partly due to associated chronic rhinitis. The child often has a wet, bubbly nose. 3. Sinusitis. Chronic maxillary sinusitis is commonly associated with adenoids. It is due to persistence of nasal discharge and infection. Reverse is also true, that a primary maxillary sinusitis may lead to infected and enlarged adenoids. 4. Epistaxis. When adenoids are acutely inflamed, epistaxy can occur with nose blowing. 5. Voice change, which is toneless and loses nasal quality due to nasal obstruction. B. Oral symptoms. 1. Tubal obstruction. Adenoid mass blocks the eustachian tube, leading to retracted tympanic membrane and conductive hearing loss. 2. Recurrent attacks of acute otitis media or infection of middle ear may occur due to spread of infection via the eustachian tube, because the eustachian tube is blocked due to adenoids hypertrophy. 3. Chronic suppurative otitis media or long-standing infection of middle ear occurs if the otitis media fails to resolve in the presence of infected adenoids. C. General symptoms. 1. Adenoid facies. Chronic nasal obstruction and mouth breathing lead to characteristic facial appearance called adenoid facies. The child has an elongated face with dull expression, prominent open mouth for breathing, and crowded upper teeth and hitched up upper lip. Nose gives a pinched-in appearance due to disuse atrophy of alae nasi. Hard palate in these cases is highly arched, as the molding action of the tongue on palate is lost because the child has to always keep the mouth open for breathing. 2. Pulmonary hypertension. In long-standing nasal obstruction due to adenoid hypertrophy, the oxygen-reaching lungs is decreased, so the blood pressure in pulmonary artery increases to carry the oxygen needed for tissues of body, which can cause pulmonary hypertension and cor pulmonale. Diagnosis. Examination of postnasal space is possible in some young children, and an adenoid mass can be seen with a mirror. Soft tissue lateral radiograph of nasopharynx will reveal the size of adenoids and also the extent to which nasopharyngeal airspace has been compromised. Detailed nasal examination should always be conducted to exclude other causes of nasal obstruction. Treatment. When symptoms are not marked, breathing exercises, decongestant nasal drops, and antihistamines for any coexistent nasal allergy can cure the condition without need of the surgery. When symptoms are marked, adenoidectomy is done for complete removal of adenoids.